Let's write down cis and trans nomenclature. Trans nomenclature we use when identical group present on the double bonded carbon atom. Double bonded carbon atom. ENZ nomenclatures. We use in case of more substituted alkane.
So could we use ENZ in case of this example that you gave us?
Sin and anti in case of nitrogen containing compound. Like suppose we have C double bond N double bond.
But is E used when both of them are on the same side or different side?
We'll discuss now. Just copy the words. We have to assign the priority first.
Priority
of the group attached onto the carbon, double bonded carbon. See, for cis and trans isomers, it's very simple. The double bonded carbon atom, if they contains identical group on the same side, P and Q, then it is cis. C double bond C, PQ, PN, R. With respect to P, we can say this is cis. Right? To find out this ENZ isomers, we have to assign priority on the group attached onto the double bonded carbon atom. Okay? So first of all, we'll assign the priority. On the group or atom attached to the double bonded carbon atom. If higher priority group on the same side, then it is Z isomer. If higher priority group are on the opposite side, it is E isomer. Okay, higher priority same side Z, higher priority opposite side E isomer.
So why do we pick Z and E?
Huh?
Why do we pick Z and E? Is there any?
It's a Greek word. I don't remember that word exactly, but according to that only. Okay, done. Now the thing is, how do we assign priority onto this? Okay, to assign priority, we have a rule and we call it as sequence rule or CIP rule. To assign priority, we have a rule, we call it as sequence or CIP rule. CIP rule, C-I-N-P, based on the name of the scientist, C stands for Khan. I is in gold.
Should I make KIP?
And P is prelog. Name of the scientist.
So is it car with a
K?
Is it car with a K?
CHN, I guess. Khan in gold and prelog. CIP rule. Okay? So what is this rule? First point to write down. Higher atomic number, will have the higher priority. So if the atoms are attached directly on the double bonded carbon atom, then we'll see the atomic number of that. Okay? Higher atomic number, higher will be the priority. Okay? Second point. In case of isotopes, we'll compare the mass number. Like if you have oxygen 18 and oxygen 16, the priority of oxygen 18 is more over oxygen 16. Chlorine 37, chlorine 35, priority order is this. Tritium and heavy. Priority order is this. We'll compare the mass number when isotopes are present.
For the second one, you
Third point. If groups are attached to the double bonded carbon atom, then we'll compare the atomic number of first atom. Okay, for example, if chlorine is there, SO3H is attached on double bonded carbon atom, hydroxy group OH attached, NH2 attached, or suppose we have COOH attached onto the double bonded carbon atom. Okay, so we'll compare the atomic number of the first atom, the atom which attached to the double bonded carbon. Sulfur here, here it is oxygen, nitrogen and carbon. Chlorine, what is the atomic number? 17. Okay. Atomic number of sulfur is 16, 8, 7 and 6. So more atomic number, more will be the priority. Okay. Priority order is this. Okay. Write on lone pair. Right on lone pair is considered to have the least priority. Lone pair we also consider as a group attached onto the double bonded atom, and that will have the least priority. Okay. C double bond C, OH, H, CH3 and assign the priority ENG cis trans whatever.
Sir, once we assign priority to these things, what do we do with that?
Okay. So first you tell me the priority here. This one and this one. See, we always assign priority on the atoms or groups which attach to the carbon atom, double bonded carbon. So this two will assign priority, 1 and 2 or 2 and 1. This two, 1 and 2 or 2 and 1. Right? So what is the priority of OH and H? Oxygen and hydrogen, right? So this is first. And this is second. What about this one? First and second. So higher priority group on the opposite side. Here it is one, here it is two. Higher priority opposite side, it is E I. Okay.
So, at what point does sysintrans not matter anymore? Like, how many C's do they have to
do? Not C. If you have all the four atoms different, then we don't assign sysintrans. Here you see, we have three different atoms, bromine, chlorine, and hydrogen. So, with respect to bromine, we can say this is cis, right? But preferred way is what? Since it is more substituted alkene, so we write it as E or Z isomer. Depending upon the priority.
I mean, like, if you have 3 C's or 4 C's or something, does cis-trans still make a difference?
Yeah.
How does 3C and 4C make a difference? This way you are saying. Like this you are saying?
Yes. Oh, it was just rotating.
So just will see the double, across the double bond. Across the double bond.
Okay.
So we always look at the priority across one of the double bonded carbon. Okay. Tritium, isotope of hydrogen. Tritium, deuterium, and then protium. What is the priority here? Which one is one? D has one. You see higher priority than hydrogen? This is one. And this two? Nitrogen, carbon. Same side? What about this one? Sin or anti? यहाँ पे don't pair है ना? So don't pair is one, OH is another.
So which one is which one is same and which one is different?
So which one is like sister,
which is sin, which is carbon. Opposite, higher priority opposite side and anti. Same side, sin. Higher priority, same side, sin. Higher priority, opposite, anti. Sin and anti we use in carbon nitrogen double bond. Sin, S-Y-N.
S-Y-N is for carbon
nitrogen. So, E-S-Y-N is nitrogen.
No.
So, if it has nitrogen,
only nitrogen, you're saying?
Yeah, if it has nitrogen, then carbon.
Then E-N-C-N are same. So, in this to the higher priority, we are left for OH. Okay, this one and one. So we can write this as cis, or preferably we'll write it as.
So what if instead of that chlorine there was an iodine? Then how would we do it? Would we still go bromine and chlorine, or would we go bromine and iodine?
I'll write on it.
So like iodine is
one. With respect to this, it is cis. And
but how would we write? Like, if we write the name, what would we write?
Preferably, we'll write E or Z. But if somewhere it is cis also written, it is not wrong. But if you write down the name of this, we'll have the E isomer of this.
So,
e.
But like with respect to bromine, it's cis. But with respect to that thing, it's trans.
Yeah. That's what. When we have substituted alkene, then we'll write E and Z. Preferably.
So, but like, would we write E or Z for this? Because with respect
to bromine,
bromine
and iodine, higher priority is this two. Opposite side is E. Cis can be E. Cis can be Z also.
Oh, cis is only for like the same type of
thing. Yes, that's what. When identical group are on the same side of double bonded carbon atom, it is cis. E or cis you can write for this. Z or cis you can write for this.
So then how is that Z if E is cis?
I didn't say E is cis. I said cis can be E or Z. It is not necessary that cis is always Z or always E. Example I have given you here. With respect to bromine, it is cis, which is understood. If you write cis, it means we are talking about with respect to bromine only. Cis, And when you assign the priority, higher priority on the opposite side, so it is E. Here you see, with respect to bromine, again it is cis. Higher priority, same side, so it is C. So cis can be E or Z. Trans can also be E and Z, right? So if it is written cis is Z and trans is E, that is not true. Understood? So write on these two examples. When opposite side, we have higher priority, opposite side, and E.
So E is always anti.
It's only defined for carbon hydrogen
and some other
nitrogen.
So, if you have an N there, is anti the same as trans, or is there another thing where like you can have cis and anti and trans?
Wait.
Ah,
what did you say?
So, if you have an N there, like it's CN, then can it be cis anti, trans anti, or is anti only like
cis? We'll write anti only.
Okay.
So E, right?
This one. For carbon, this one. I don't know. I just drawn it randomly, sir. We'll see. This two, which one is the higher priority? Water one. Why?
The same,
because
sir.
Because it has 4 months.
Same carbon.
Sir, but only the first carbon atom
matches. Okay, see here. See, if you have like this subsiding structure is attached, then how do we compare? This carbon atom, let it be here. This carbon atom is this. What is the first atom?
Carbon.
What is the first atom here? Carbon. Right? Here also we have carbon. We'll open up this thing. Either you can go clockwise or anti-clockwise, one by one each atom. Huh? I said this carbon is here. This attached is one carbon, this attached another carbon. So these two are the carbon atoms. Then we go this way. Clockwise. You can go anti-clockwise.
So both have to be clockwise or
anti-clockwise. Clockwise, anti-clockwise. So carbon, then what we get? Oxygen. Then carbon. Carbon, oxygen, and then carbon. Still here.
We write the first one again.
Yes. Here what happens? Carbon, oxygen, carbon, 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 oxygen, and carbon. Now we'll compare one by one, right? So this we have carbon only, so we cannot compare carbon-carbon, we cannot decide. Oxygen-oxygen, we cannot decide. Carbon-carbon, we cannot decide. Carbon-carbon, we cannot decide. Here we can decide, right? Oxygen has more priority over carbon. It means this group has higher priority over this group.
So
right.
What if going clockwise and anti-clockwise gives us different results?
They won't give you. So this is smaller ring, first priority, this is second priority. Here also you can compare and you will get the smaller ring as higher priority. So this one is... Understood? Okay. Similar ring, if it is present, smaller ring will have the higher priorities. Okay, so all these, you know, nomenclature we have discussed is trans, EZ, sin, and D.